So Richard just showed you some of the flaws with HTTP1 and said that HTTP2 would solve them. But how does it do it? Well, take out your note-taking pencil because I'm about to show you the wonders of HTTP2.
Remember the human readability of requests and response headers? Well, that's gotta go. It's the first step to improve performance with HTTP2. It was nice while it lasted, but nobody is really benefiting from the plain text approach that HTTP1 took. We are wasting precious bytes by spelling things out in text form when a single bit is sufficient. Don't worry though, tools like Wireshark or DevTools will still let you see headers even with HTTP2. The second big problem HTTP2 solves is head-of-line blocking. It does this through a technique called multiplexing. Multiplexing is a fancy-sounding term that means combining multiple signals into a new single signal. With HTTP2, we now have one connection instead of six. That seems like a terrible step backwards at first, but we are using the single connection differently than HTTP1 would have. What used to be a dedicated connection in HTTP1 is now called a stream, and all streams share that single connection. These streams are split up into frames and are being multiplexed onto that single connection. When one stream is blocked, another stream can take over the connection and make good use of what would have been idle time. Head-of-line blocking be gone. Lastly, HTTP2 takes care of header data being uncompressed. With HTTP2, headers are not just being compressed with gzip. The engineers came up with an HTTP2 compression that is tailored towards the specific structure of headers and the multiplexing feature of HTTP2. All streams not only share the connection, but also the compressor. This means a header never has to be sent twice, since the compressor recognizes that it's been sent before and sends a reference instead. For example, cookies are really long headers, so it is an enormous advantage to say, insert the same cookie header as 3 requests ago here, instead of the actual value. I won't go into the intricacies of this compression algorithm, but if you're interested in how it works, there is some additional reading in the instructor notes.